टेक्नोलॉजी टेक्निकल टिप्स एंड ट्रिक एंड हाउ के लिए आप मेरे चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करें और बेल बटन को क्लिक करके ईमेल नोटिफिकेशन को इनेबल कर लें।
मैं आनंद फ्रॉम आनंद टेक्निकल सपोर्ट। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस ओवर 5G-NR प्रोटोकॉल स्टैक। व्हेन वी क्लोजली सी बोथ प्रोटोकॉल LTE एंड 5G, वी कुड सी मेनी सिमिलरिटी बिटवीन द LTE प्रोटोकॉल स्टैक एंड 5G-NR प्रोटोकॉल स्टैक। बिकॉज़ LTE प्रोटोकॉल स्टैक इज बीइंग टेकन एज बेसलाइन for the 5G-NR development. 5G-NR user plane contain 5 MAC, RLC and PDCP and it is same as LTE. But in 5G-NR has introduced a new layer. Its name is SDAP, Service Data Application Protocol. On another side, the control plane of 5G-NR is identical to LTE. In LTE, MME is the main signaling node in the EPC. But in 5G, MME is replaced by MF, Access and Mobility. Now, one by one, I will discuss over all the 5G-NR layer. First one is Layer 3, RRC. System information related messages like access stratum and non-access stratum related message will be broadcast by RRC. Paging related messages, RRC connection establishment, maintenance, RRC connection release, these all the messages are transferred between UE and GNOME and it is taken care by RRC layer. 5G-NR RRC is also responsible for security function including key management. In RRC also responsible for in carrier aggregation for SL addition, modification and release. Dual connectivity between IOTA and NR. Dual connectivity, that means device is connected with two cells, IOTA and NR. So it's also taken care by the RRC. RRC is responsible for SRB, DRB establishment, configuration and release. RRC involves in mobility scenario like handover, context transfer, UE, cell selection, reselection and control part of the selection and reselection. Internet mobility, these all the scenario RRC is responsible for these all the things. Cost management related things, RRC also responsible for the UE management reporting and control the reporting. So detection of the recovery of radio link failure, NAS message transfer, these all the things is taken care by RRC. It is a layer 2 function. Layer 2 of 5G is splitted into 4 sub-layer. Service Data Adaptation Protocol, SDAP, Protocol Data Convergence Protocol, PDCP, Radio Link Control, RLC, Medium Access Control, MAC. In this pics, we can see Layer 2 architecture for downlink and uplink. Here you can see physical layer offered to the MAC sublayer transport channel. MAC sublayer offered to the RLC sublayer logical channel. RLC sublayer offered to the PDCP sublayer RLC channel. PDCP sublayer offered to the SDAP sublayer radio bearer. SDAP sublayer offered to the 5G cost flow. So these are the flow and how it's handled we can see here. First sublayer part of layer 2 is SDAP, Service Data Adaption Protocol. SDAP is responsible for the mapping between a quality of service flow from the 5G core network and data radio bearer, as well as marking the quality of service flow identifier QFI in uplink and downlink packet. The reason for the introduction of SDAP in 5G is the new quality of service handling compared to LTE. When UE connected to 5G core, SDAP is responsible for the mapping between cost flow and radio bearer. If GNODB is connected to EPC, in this case it is non-standalone mode and SDAP will not use. PDCP, Packet Data Convergence Protocol. PDCP perform the IP header compression to reduce the number of bits to transmit over the radio interface. Header compression mechanism is based on robust header compression (ROSC). PDCP is also responsible for the ciphering to protect user data. For the control plane, PDCP use integrity protection to ensure signaling data. PDCP is also responsible for duplicate detection removal in case of handover and delivered downlink data packet will be forwarded by the PDCP from old GNODB to new GNODB. In this case, some PDU may be received in duplicated. In this case, PDCP will remove the duplicated packet. PDCP also configured to perform the reordering to ensure in-sequence delivery of SDU. Dual connectivity is another area where PDCP play an important role. In dual connectivity, device is connected to two cells. In general, you can see a two cell group. One is the master cell group and second cell is connected to a secondary cell group. This two cell group can be handled by different GNOME. Radio bearer is typically handled by one of the cell group, but there is also the possibility for a split bearer, in which case one radio bearer is handled by both cell group. In this case, the PDCP is responsible for distributing the data between master cell group and secondary cell group. Now, radio link control (RLC). RLC is responsible for the segmentation and resegmentation handling. There is one RLC entity per RLC channel configured for device. Compared to LTE, 5G RLC does not support in-sequence delivery of data to higher protocol layer and also no involvement in concatenation. Actually, this change is applied due to reduce in packet delay. Some other function, error correction through performed by the ARC, reassembling the SDU, RLC re-establishment, these all the facility of RLC. MAC, next is MAC, Medium Access Control. MAC facility is the mapping between the logical and transport channel. Medium Access Control handle multiplexing and logical channel. Multiplexing and demultiplexing of MAC SDU belonging to one or different logical channel into transport block delivered to a physical layer through the transport channel. Scheduling information, scheduling facility is located in GNOME for both uplink and downlink. Error correction through the HARC is handled. HARC will handle the error correction. Priority handling between the UEs by means of dynamic scheduling also taken care by the MAC. A single MAC entity can support one or multiple numerology and TTI duration. Due to multiple numerology, there is some restriction on channel prioritization control, and it's decided on different condition where we can use the numerology type and TTI duration. क्योंकि Mac में काफी सारे numerology use होते हैं और different उसका TTI है, तो ये इसके कारण क्या है, उसकी जो channel prioritization control है वो decide करता है और different condition पे कौन सा condition certify करता है, उस condition के अनुसार से वो numerology type and TTI decide होता है. Next is 5G physical layer. 5G layer 1 is responsible for error detection on the transport channel and indication to a higher layer. Higher soft box combining is also part of 5 layer. Red matching of the coded transport channel onto a physical channel is also taken care by 5 layer. Power weighting of physical channel, modulation and demodulation of physical channel, frequency and time synchronizations, multiple antenna like MIMO mapping is also taken care by physical layer. Forward error correction, it is used as an encoder at the transmitter, which add redundancy to the information sample before transmitting the encoder sequence over channel. At the receiver, it's recover the data sample and decode the channel using channel distortion and forward error correction. LDPC is the 5G-NR use the LDPC for channel coding on traffic channel and polar codes used for control channel. LDPC used for the traffic channel and polar codes used for the control channel. LDPC correct channel error by maintaining priority bit for a selection of the data bit. So it was the complete picture of protocol stack. So if it helpful for you, then please subscribe my channel and thanks for watching this video. Bye, take care.
So friends, आज का वीडियो मैं यहीं पे समाप्त करता हूँ. थैंक्स फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो. अगर आपको मेरा वीडियो पसंद आया हो तो प्लीज़ लाइक एंड कमेंट करें, और अगर आप मेरे चैनल पर नए हैं तो प्लीज़ सब्सक्राइब करें, क्योंकि मैं हमेशा कुछ नए टॉपिक पे वीडियो लाता रहता हूँ और उसका नोटिफिकेशन आपको मिलता रहेगा. सो थैंक्स फॉर वॉचिंग वीडियो.